Okay, I want to show you the problems and then show you kind of what I'm expecting to see for your work for these. So 1 through 4, they are going to give you graphs. And they're going to give you equations, and this is just matching, but it's a little bit more than just matching. So if you're doing these problems, what I would like you to do for number one is to write down both of those equations, x equals 4 cosine cubed t, and y equals 2 sine cubed t. And our job is going to be to match it to one of these graphs. How do you suppose we're going to do that? Yeah, we'll use our calculator. So now I want you using the calculator rather than Desmos. So we're going to graph it. Now what do we need to do to get this graphed? We need to get back into parametric mode. And we might need to change our dot back to a circle. Now, 4 cosine cubed t. How are you going to put that into your calculator? Oh, well, let me show you. You're going to go 4 parentheses cosine t and the parentheses to the third power. So you're going to put a big parenthesis around your cosine t and do a fourth power on that parenthesis. And I'm going to graph this in the standard zoom. Now, part of this problem is figuring out what do we need to change the zoom to so that our graph looks like the ones that they're showing here. So let's hit graph and hopefully we'll see something that looks familiar to us from these four. Oops, do zoom 6. Yeah, I did standard zoom. Oh, that looks a lot like B, but mine is smaller than that. So they want us to fix our window and write down what our window is. Okay, that's part of what the instructions say. Identify the viewing window that seems to have been used. So I need to fix my X min, X max, Y min, and Y max. If you look at this graph, what would you guess the X min is? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, negative 5. It looks like it's going negative 5 to 5. And in the y direction, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's try negative 5 to 5 in the x and the y direction. That's looking better. It looks like it might, but I don't know for sure. They could be doing like negative 10 to 10 with a step of 2. Remember that the x step and the y step tells you how many steps are in between. So to finish this, okay, just so we're all on the same page, my expectation, you're going to draw yourself a little calculator screen. Oh my goodness, yeah, I know this is going to take so long. And you're going to make a just quick and dirty sketch of this thing. I know I expect so much. And I also want you to write, what are you using for your window? Negative 5 to 5 and negative 5 to 5. I know. You'll be all right, though. All right, so there's number one. Let's have a look at the other section. So save yourself enough room to do 3 more of those. Let's have a look at number 5, please. So number 5, they're asking you to just fill in the table. We're going to just fill in the table. So you're just going to copy this table down onto your page. you'll write these two equations down and then graph it. This is just like what we did in our lesson. If you'd rather make this table go vertically rather than horizontally, I'm fine with that. Any questions about that? We're not going to do five together. All right, let's look at number seven. The instructions here say graph the parametric equation, and they've given us the equation here, and the specified parameter interval uses a standard viewing window. So we are going to graph this, and then we're going to be sketching it. So wherever you're going to do this, let's write down for 7 and 9, because we're only doing odds, is that correct? So for 7 and 9, let's write down what our equations are. Remember, folks, we're not just putting answers down. I want you to be able to look at this 2 months from now and know what you were doing. I know. Well, you're going to get bored over the summer, and you're going to be like, let's go back and look at some pre-calc. So number seven, now we need to use the standard viewing window. T is 0 to 10. So let's go ahead and go into our calculator. Type in our two equations. Here's a helpful hint. If you don't hit clear, you won't have to redo the, you can't see my screen, sorry, thank you. If you use the delete to delete it instead of clear, then you won't have, then it won't erase your little bubble. I don't know if that's saves you whole seconds of your life. You're welcome. 2t. And in number 7, they want us to use t values from 0 to 10. So we need to go into our window settings and change it so our t values are going to go from 0 to 10. So window, we're going to change it from 0 to 10. Now I got a feeling we're not going to be able to see all of this, because if I plug 10 into that second equation, we're going to get 20. If I plug 10 into the first equation, I get negative 97. But we'll sketch as much of it as we can. Whoa! That was quick. Oh, are we on Zoom standard, Zoom 6? No, I'm not. Go back to Zoom. They asked us to do it in the standard Zoom window. And then you're going to make a sketch. So for number 7, let's write down the pertinent information. 0 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 10. And then we'll make a sketch of what it looks like. To me, it looks like it's... You guys can't see my sketch. Well, you can see your screen. To me, it looks like it's starting at 3 and it crosses somewhere between maybe 3 and 4. It goes off in that direction. And I think that's all they ask, right? Use the standard viewing window. All right, leave yourself space for number 9. And then in 11 through 25, you are going to be eliminating the parameter. That's like that last problem that we did. Some of these are pretty simple. If you look at number 11, both of these equations would be relatively simple to solve for t, but which one would be easier to solve for t? The y is already solved for t, isn't it? This is going to be pretty simple for this, okay? Now, I do want you, it says identify the graph of the parametric curve. What they mean by that is it linear? Is it quadratic? Is it sinusoidal? Is it exponential? So I have a feeling this one will be linear, but if you're unsure, you can always graph it and look at it. Yeah, let's just do 11 right now. 11's really simple. Let's just do 11. Let's do a harder one. We will look at a harder one in a moment. X equals 1 plus t. Y equals t. I'd say we've already got an equation that's solved for t. T is equal to y, so we'll take that y, we'll put it in for t here. We get x equals 1 plus y. I'd say if it's relatively easy to get y by itself, let's go ahead and get y by itself. Let's get this as a function of y. X minus 1 equals y. My final answer would be y equals x minus 1. And then I would say linear. Why are they telling us 3 to 5? I wonder. Yeah, you can ignore the whole 3 to 5 thing. Just do the same thing. Solve one of them for t. I mean, this first one, add 3 on both sides and divide by 2, and then plug it in your other equation and simplify it. Now, I do want to talk about... let's talk about 24, which is not one of your problems. X equals 4 cosine t, y equals 4 sine t. You guys writing this down? I know we're getting close here. When you get a problem like this that's got sines and cosines in it, my suggestion to you is don't try and solve for t. Use this instead. Let's solve for cosine. So this would be x over 4 equals cosine t, and y over 4 equals sine t. All right, you ready? Watch this action. What do you know about cosine squared t plus sine squared t? Equals 1, right? All right, so what can we put in place of cosine? X over 4, and what can we put in place of sine? Y over 4, right? There you go. No more t's. You're going to do something very similar on 23 and 25. And this graph is a circle. Okay. Thank you, guys.